his cattle forsake his way, and the wicked his thoughts. Let him turn to the Lord for mercy, to our God, who is generous and forgiving. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, nor are your ways my ways, says the Lord. As high as the heavens are above the earth, so high are my ways above your ways, and my thoughts above your thoughts. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
St. Paul to the Philippians, brothers and sisters. Christ will be magnified in my body, whether by life or by death. For to me, life is Christ and death is gain. If I go on living in the flesh, that means fruitful labor for me. And I do not know which I shall choose. I am caught between the two. I long to depart this life and be with Christ, for that is far better. Yet that I remain in the flesh is more necessary for your benefit. Only conduct yourselves in a way worthy of the gospel of Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus told his disciples this parable. The kingdom of heaven is like a landowner who went out at dawn to hire laborers for his vineyard. After agreeing with them for the usual daily wage, he sent them into his vineyard. Going out about 9 o'clock, the landowner saw others standing idle in the marketplace. And he said to them, "You too go into my vineyard, and I will give you what is just." So they went off. And he went out again around noon and around 3 o'clock and did likewise. Going out about 5 o'clock, the landowner found others standing around and said to them, "Why do you stand here idle all day?" They answered, "Because no one has hired us." He said to them, "You too go into my vineyard." When it was evening, the owner of the vineyard said to his foreman, "Summon the laborers and give them their pay, beginning with the last and ending with the first." When those who had started about 5 o'clock came, each received the usual daily wage. So, when the first came, they thought that they would receive more. But each of them also got the usual daily wage. And on receiving it, they grumbled against the landowner, saying, "These last ones worked only an hour, and you have made them equal to us, who bore the day's burden and the heat?" He said to one of them in reply, "My friend, I am not cheating you. Did you not agree with me for the usual daily wage? Take what is yours and go. What if I wish to give this last one the same as you? Or am I not free to do as I wish with my own money? Are you envious because I am generous?" Thus, the last will be first, and the first will be last. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you, Lord.
Loudness of various sorts of grievances are not always
When belief in God begins to decline, when you know, across society there's a decline in actual belief in God, then what happens? Well, we all have a need to have some kind of ultimate sense of or ultimate purpose, and what happens is, at least it seems I don't know, and it made some sense to me, is that we invest now, or we invest these ultimate concerns in matters that are, in the matters of the world, the political things. So political things become, they are invested with this ultimate meaning, the stakes are so high for them, you know, it's a matter of do or die, and so we hold on to our, you know, grievances tight, because there's no other, there's nothing else that we have. This becomes the source of our meaning. I think there's something to be said for that. To put that in somewhat different terms, I think what we're dealing with nowadays is certainly the demand for justice, which is oftentimes a very, very good thing, is clearly present. And everybody is seeking justice for various causes within themselves, etc. But when you have justice that is, to use the words of our tradition, justice that is untempered by mercy. You heard that expression, right? Justice that is tempered by mercy. If you have justice without mercy, what's going to happen? Well, you have this really hard kind of, you know, conflictual kind of relationship with others. You're going to go to the barriers in order to defend your position, and you don't allow anybody, any room. You don't allow any space for disagreement, and you don't allow space for mercy. And again, from the point of view of our own Christian faith, that is especially problematic because of the fact that if we understand ourselves well, then we know the extent to which we ourselves have relied upon the mercy of God in our lives. And in our reluctance sometimes, our reluctance to extend or to begrudge, our tendency to begrudge the extension of that mercy to others, is something that I think is a particular temptation in our own time, and a danger that we need to be aware of and to try to give a genuine Christian witness, to as we ourselves come in the mercy of God, that we have to be merciful towards those who are different than ourselves and those who hold very different opinions in ourselves. Not to say that we have to compromise our opinions, but we have to make sure that our holding tight to those opinions doesn't cause us to actually eliminate the possibility of extending mercy to others. So let's pray in the midst of our social dysfunction, I would call it nowadays. Let's pray that what the Christian faith can really bring to the situation we find ourselves in is the recognition of God's ways are not our ways, as the first reading says, and that God invites us to accept God's mercy for ourselves and to be willing to extend that mercy to others. God bless you.
true God. God not made, what is essential with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the Holy Spirit, he was born of the Virgin Mary and became a man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. And he was buried the third day, according to the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and stood at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds with the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is glorified and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church, I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
With trust and confidence now, let us bring before the Lord our prayers and petitions.
For the Church, that we may humbly accept God's gift of salvation and recognize that every day is God's gift to us, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the world, and countries rich in agricultural or technological resources, may be generous in sharing these benefits with nations in need. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For young people who are in religious education, especially those who are preparing for the reception of sacraments this year, that they may grow in their knowledge and love of God and in their commitment to the Christian community, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an end to violence in local communities, that God will open the hearts of local leaders to address the injustices in their communities and promote dialogue and new understanding among citizens. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those departed who believed in Jesus Christ and were sealed with the Holy Spirit, and particularly for Elias the Aquino, whose funeral was celebrated this past week, and especially for Cliff Labassiere and Uriel Pacific, for whom this Mass is being offered. May they be raised up on the last day to live forever. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our
prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the love which shines so brightly in the life, death, and resurrection of your Son Jesus. We ask you now to hasten to help us in our world in its great need, and to answer the prayers we offer in your name. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Today's second collection is for Catholic Schools Appeal. Thank you for your generosity. As our gifts are presented and the altars are cleared, please join in our offertory hymn number 636. Now thank you all our God. 636.
Thank you.
Christ that you have been, and his glory in his name, for our good and good all his holy church.
Receive with favor, O Lord, we pray, the offerings of your people, that what they profess with devotion and faith may be theirs through these heavenly mysteries, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you laid the foundations of the world and have arranged the changing of times and seasons. You formed man in your own image and set humanity over the whole world in all its wonder, to rule in your name over all you have made, and forever praise you for your mighty works with Christ our Lord. Amen. And so with all the angels we praise you as a joyful celebration. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving thanks, he said a blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. is holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May you make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may attain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, your spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. Joseph Lima, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm the faith and charity of your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Robert, our bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your home. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, merciful Father, gather to yourself all of your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you in their passing from this life, once again, in a particular way, at this Mass, we remember Cliff Labossiere and Muriel Pacific. Give time and admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lord.
Lord, I am
take my cane.
Let us pray. Graciously raise up, O Lord, those who renew with this sacrament, that we may come to possess your redemption both in mystery and in the manner of our life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Join us.
so much fun. Walk, run, or be like me, sit and enjoy everyone else walking and running while you can still. I don't know. So that's always fun. Don't miss the coffee. This year we have bingo, which is going to be a lot of fun. And also, brand new to this event is Saturday night, doors open at 6:30. We are having our first, we hope will be annual, St. Rose Pub Trivia Night. This is a 21-year-older event. It's a BYOB, so come challenge your wits. We have teams of eight and challenge your wits against others in our community. General questions, St. Rose questions, everything. It'll be an assortment. It'll be a lot of fun, and it's a make-your-own-taco event. So we hope you come and join us. And finally, our Parish Day of Service, November 4th. We are so very excited for this first, again, hopefully annual day of service. We're going to gather in the morning for a faith-filled send-off. You can choose the event that you want to participate in. We'll find out what events are good for families, for young children, for older, whether you're single, whether you're with a family, whether you join any friends. We hope you participate in this event. It's really where we put our faith in action. Some of the places we'll be serving are here at the parish or out in the community. The mustard seed, little store, there's many different places. You'll find them all online once we get that up next week. It really is a chance to get together, serve side by side with other people, get to know the community more, and most importantly, letting our community, our greater community, know how much we care and want to help them as well. So we hope you'll join us in this great event. That's it. Thanks for your patience. Have a wonderful week. And in the words of Father Juan, on behalf of all the staff and Father Juan and up here, love you all.
Thanks be to God.